Welcome to Tython, Padawan. Everyone at the temple is looking forward to meeting you. Your former masters praise your combat skills. They say you're becoming an expert duelist.
It's easy to excel when you're trained by the best.
The Jedi Council will assign you a new master to oversee your final trials. You'll be tested in ways you can't imagine. But when you leave Tython, you'll know what it means to be a Jedi Knight. More importantly, you'll know yourself.
I'm eager to face these trials. Where do I start?
There's a speeder here that will take you to... Hang on. Getting an emergency signal. Flesh Raiders? Armed with blasters? He must be mistaken.
Mistaken or not, that Padawan is under attack.
They've never come this close before. Flesh Raiders are a species of hostile natives. They're smart enough to use tools and violent beyond reason. I'm sending every able-bodied Jedi down to the Padawan training grounds right away. Especially you.
Just point the way. I'll handle the rest.
Take the speeder outside to the training grounds, push back the Flesh Raiders, and find out if they're really using advanced weapons. Go. I'll catch up with you after I alert the Jedi Council. May the Force be with you.
Padawan, come here, quickly. The training grounds are not safe today.
Knight Weller sent me to help with the Flesh Raiders. I'm combat trained and ready to help.
And the Force is with us. Few Padawans here can make that claim. The Flesh Raiders moved into the training grounds, organized and ready, attempting to isolate various groups of Padawans. There's a group of students in the hills we lost track of. They're not combat trained.
Don't worry. Those Padawans will get home safe. I promise.
I've got a beacon here. If you can find the Padawans and set the beacon, we'll send an evac shuttle as fast as we can. A group of Jedi from the temple is headed this way, but maybe not fast enough. May the Force be with you.
How's he looking?
He should be resting in the Jedi Temple, but if you're determined to press on, I can help him along.
Give him the last of the Colto if you have to. We'll fight again soon. Hey! Good to see another Padawan alive out here. You're lucky those creatures haven't caught you yet.
I've been searching for you. What happened out here?
Knew they'd sent rescuers.
We came seeking knowledge of the Jedi Code. The Flesh Raiders interrupted our trial.
Never fought like that in my life. We killed it, but Jaradin was badly injured.
Your friend, how serious is the wound?
It pains him greatly. He should not be moving. It is not the Jedi way to seek battle and revenge while a man suffers.
That's your opinion, Menaeus. It's not what we decided. Training or not, a bunch of animals won't keep us from becoming Jedi.
Isn't she right? Jedi don't give up, do they?
She is wrong. Remember the Jedi Code. There is no passion. There is serenity.
That's enough, Menaeus. If you want to help us, we could use you. Help make the Flesh Raiders pay.
You're walking a dangerous path. You and your friends need to get back to camp while you still can.
But we're so close to finishing the trial.
No, we are not. I see you have a signal beacon. Leave it for us, and as soon as we have gathered our things, we will signal for a ride back.
Unharmed. Good. Flesh Raider shot me in the leg while I was rescuing some Padawans. Don't know where these things got blasters, but I know how to use them. I've been evacuated to a med center, but the fighting isn't over.
I'll push back the enemy, whatever it takes.
We need to stop them at the source. Another Padawan found a cave tunnel the Flesh Raiders used to enter this valley. I need you at that tunnel.
making sure the Flesh Raiders don't get any more reinforcements through it.
I'll find this cave tunnel and seal it.
We need to end this conflict before anyone else gets hurt. Find the tunnel along the mountain range. May the Force be with you.
The beacon worked, and a rescue speeder is on its way. You really came through for those Padawans.
One of them was injured. You need to send a medic with the rescue team.
Standard procedure. They're in good hands. You probably want to get back to your trials. Again, thank you, and may the Force be with you.
Stop struggling, Padawan. Your life was over the moment you set foot here. Because the Order must evolve, and you are weak.
Whoever you are, step away from that Padawan.
You are dangerous. You killed my soldiers. Not attacking, cleansing. And we have only begun.
Lay down your weapons. I don't want to hurt you.
The old order is dead. Long live the new order.
You two all right? What happened here? Thank the Force that you're both safe. This man's no Jedi. At least not one of us.
He organized the attack on the training grounds. Called the Flesh Raiders his soldiers.
I warned the Council these natives aren't mindless beasts. This is proof.
This lightsaber, there's something familiar about it. Strange.
You held off all these attackers by yourself with only a practice saber. Impressive.
I followed my instincts, that's all.
They served you well. This battle's over, but we don't want any more Flesh Raiders coming through here. That should hold them back for now.
I can see why you're a Jedi Master.
When you get as old as me, you learn a few tricks. Not yet. I'll get you to a med center. You seem all right to travel alone. Report to the Jedi Council.
This valley isn't safe yet. I don't feel good about leaving.
We have Jedi Knights rooting out the last attackers. You're needed elsewhere. Follow the path leading out of this valley. You'll find the Jedi Temple through the mountain pass. See you there.
Padawan, I heard you've begun your trials. Master Orgus speaks very highly of you. No doubt you're pleased to have come this far. But some Jedi have the ability to do more, help more people. Interested?
What's involved in this assignment?
A war is brewing in the greater galaxy. The Sith Empire plots against the Republic, and the Republic looks to the Jedi for aid. But not all who train to become Jedi are skilled combatants and leaders. Many are scholars, diplomats, strategists, and scientists. Which is why we've created a simulation to test Jedi and Padawans and certify them to lead Republic troops.
You want me to participate in this simulation?
That's what I'm asking. The droids here in the Yard have been programmed to act according to Imperial military protocols and battlefield tactics. Demonstrate your proficiency at defeating these droids, and you will be on your way to qualifying to lead Republic troops into battle. Can you do it?
You can count on me.
Excellent. The first set of training droids are ready for you. Get to it. That was an impressive go earlier. but we've upped the programming on these droids. Care to give it another shot? Get out there and show them what you're made of. We're going to have to get you a real challenge. You made it look easy. Your last round with the droids was impressive, but we've made modifications to their behavior that should make for a real challenge. Unbelievable! I don't think I've ever seen anything like that. But I've still got a few more tricks. All right, this is it. You've been tearing through these droids about as fast as I can repair them. But we just received the latest combat simulation data from the Republic and combined it with the data we've collected from your earlier fights. It'll be tough, but if you can do this, there'll be nothing more we can throw at you. You'll be fully qualified to lead Republic troops in battle. Unbelievable! To tell the truth, I didn't think it was possible. I think you've more than qualified for the job of leading Republic soldiers in battle. Here's your certification. Congratulations. Amazing.
Peace unto you, friend. I bear word from the masters of the temple. Will you take a moment and hear my message?
By all means, my friend. Let us talk.
You do me great honor. Your present mission is all important, but the Masters want to make sure you do not miss what the Temple has to offer. When you have time, see Master Mujida. He will guide you in the other skills of the Jedi.
Padawan, I'm Satil Shan, leader of the Jedi Council. I'd like to speak privately with you before we meet with the others.
You have my full attention, Master. What do you need?
This isn't a discussion for a comm channel. Come to my meditation room in the Temple. We'll talk there.
Welcome, Padawan. The temple is already buzzing with accounts of your heroism in the training grounds. Master Orgus told me you battled flesh raiders, and a force user armed with a lightsaber. That must have been a disturbing confrontation. Are you all right?
I'm sorry things ended in violence, but I'm glad to be alive.
Taking a life affects the living force, and the one who does the killing. This is why Jedi enter battles calmly, with reason. Emotions like fear and anger lead to the dark side.
The man I fought wasn't angry or fearful.
Not on the surface, perhaps. As the Jedi Code teaches us, there is no emotion, there is peace. Remember those words when times are darkest. And take this. The Code is a source of strength, but some backup never hurts. I'll see you soon in the Council Chambers.
I searched the temple archives. This force user leading the flesh raiders never received Jedi training.
Then the Sith have found us. Shouldn't we get ready for them?
Calm yourself, Padawan. We can't be certain of anything yet.
But we've all sensed a growing darkness. Perhaps it's finally revealed itself.
The enemy I faced wanted to destroy the Jedi Order. Can't get much darker than that.
Well, that brightened up the room.
Everyone, this is the Padawan who saved our people in the training grounds. This is Master Kiwix and her extremely vocal Padawan, Kira. The other masters are transmitting from distant worlds.
It's unfortunate our numbers are scattered.
Indeed. The temple's safety is unexpectedly threatened. The Flesh Raiders were disorganized primitives before today.
They carry blasters and work like an army. We need to find out why.
The man leading the Flesh Raiders probably wasn't acting alone.
Much of Tython remains unexplored, and we have few resources to spare.
I'll handle it with the help of my new Padawan.
Orgus, you haven't taken a Padawan since Coruscant.
The Force is strong in him, stronger than I've seen in decades.
I can think of no finer master to complete this Padawan's training.
It will be a privilege.
Don't get too excited. You're in for some hard work. You'll find supplies in my chambers downstairs. Go equip yourself. I'll meet you there. Those council meetings. I'd die of old age before my colleagues ran out of things to say.
Have you always felt this way about your fellow masters?
Don't misunderstand. They're good people. I just prefer to get things done. This situation has come to you fast. You're braving dangers many Jedi never face. I wouldn't blame you for having questions. This may be the only time to ask them.
I get the impression you haven't had a Padawan for years. Why did you ask to train me?
As Jedi, you learn to trust your instincts. When I met you in that cave, my instincts told me that I was meant to train you. I don't know why or for what purpose, but the living force brought us together for a reason.
You think the force is alive? That it wants something from us?
Want is too strong a word. Let's just say we'll accomplish more together than by ourselves. There's a group of Twi'lek pilgrims on Tython. They've been fighting the Flesh Raiders for months. The Republic asked us to deny those Twi'lek's aid. They settled here illegally, but frankly, we need them.
How are they violating the law?
When Tython was first rediscovered, the Twi'leks petitioned the Senate to settle here. Their claim was denied, too dangerous. But they came anyway. The Twi'leks have a settlement in the mountains. That's your next stop. Establish a base camp and speak to the Matriarch. Find out everything the Twi'leks know about Flesh Raiders.
Anything you can tell me about the Twi'lek leader?
Word is, she's not our biggest fan. You may have to convince her otherwise. I'll join you soon. May the Force be with you.
I seem to be cursed. Why do I always get the pupils who think they're the exceptions to the rule?
Master Silvarte, it's true that our Padawans are acting a bit strangely, but I don't think there's cause for concern.
Wait, I have an idea. You, Padawan, I know you.
I'm sorry, I don't believe we've met, Master.
Thank you, I stand corrected, youngster. I only know of you.
Master Silvarte is concerned about a couple of our Padawans. He suspects that they are, well...
If I'm correct, they are following their passions down a dark path.
Am I to understand that love leads to the dark side?
Emotions disrupt balance. When you hold one person in higher regard than others, it clouds clarity and twists reason. We mustn't stand by.
In all other aspects, these two are model pupils, but I agree we would be remiss if we didn't do what we can to settle the issue.
They may be more open and revealing with a student like you. We need you to confront them and discover if they are indeed cultivating a romance.
If they're breaking the Jedi Code, I promise you, I will find out.
Their names are Morrison and Spanios. As we speak, they are in the ruins of Lower Kaleth.
So go, talk with them, and report back what you discover about the relationship. Try not to alert or alarm them. If they are in love, they are sure to be volatile.
You found it! Well done, Morrison.
Oh, Spanios, I couldn't have done it without you.
You're amazing. I don't care what the Masters say, we're proving everyone wrong. Come here and give me a kiss.
Well, it seems your Master's concerns were valid.
Who are you?
This isn't what you think it is.
I think you two are romantically involved.
Okay, maybe it is what you think it is.
Spanios!
I'm sorry, my love. But I'm sick of hiding. The order is wrong. Fear, not emotion, is the adversary of the Jedi way. Ironically, the Masters fear emotion, and therefore, they deny us its bounty.
The power of our love is why we work so well together. Our teamwork allowed us to find this rare lightsaber crystal. So our passion actually strengthens the order.
Maybe you're right, but it's not for me to decide.
Spanios. Please help me convince this upstart not to expose us.
I love you, Morrison. And so if you believe we must remain hidden, I honor that. But it may take a sacrifice.
You mean the crystal? I agree, my love.
Friend, if you tell the Masters we're not romantically involved, we'll give you this powerful crystal for your future lightsaber. Would that buy your silence?
I'll decide what to do when I return to the Masters.
We will hold out hope.
If you tell the Masters you found nothing suspicious here, come back to us, and we'll give you the crystal.
Don't you dare try to fool us. We will know if you do.
Were you successful, Padawan? Did you find our pupils in the ruins?
Tell us, what did you uncover about the nature of Spanius and Morrison's relationship? Are they romantically involved?
I discovered that there is no romance between them, Masters.
You see, Master Silvarte, your concerns were for naught.
I am relieved to hear this. Surprised, but most relieved. You've handled this matter with great character. The Order is fortunate to have you in the fold.
Believe me, you give me more credit than I deserve.
Humility is a virtue, young one. Now that you've befriended them, you might check in on our students. Otherwise, good luck with the rest of your training.
Well, our blackmailer returns. Back for the crystal, no doubt. Thank you for keeping our secret.
I changed my mind. I'm not here to accept the bribe. Just to wish you both the best.
You amaze me, my friend, but I think I understand. You're giving us a chance to end our relationship and find our way back to the code ourselves, right?
You have me all wrong. You two should continue to follow your passion.
See, my love, our friend here has been transformed by our love.
Then I'm filled with hope. Thank you, friend. Be well.
It's impossible! Why would my master assign me a trial that can't be done?
Is something wrong here?
Oh, you startled me. I didn't see you approach. My master says there are valuable materials behind that boulder over there. But get this, the blasted thing can't be moved. My instructions were to go to a platform in the ruins. Meditate and let the Force empower me. But I've meditated till I can't see straight and nothing.
Maybe you should just try again.
Ah, you have no idea how long I've been at this! So I'm gonna get drummed out of the Order because I can't move a rock that can't be moved. It's absurd! Hey, what if maybe you could help me? Are you good at this meditation thing?
I don't know. But I'm game to try.
Oh, thank you. You're a lifesaver. So, just kneel at the altar nearby. Supposedly, if you find deep inner peace, you'll be able to move the boulder. If you fail, I can tell my master it wasn't just me who couldn't move it. I can't decide if I'm ashamed that I couldn't do it or happy that my mission is complete. There was supposed to be something important behind the boulder.
It would appear we were mistaken.
But...
Iniki!
Master Quilljake, why are you here?
Wana wada blota wi jawa. O wama wanka matuske. Manchi doti puna puna. Kabuk nuni snemo. Kunta chuta. Kasuyali kulira, tanki kung.
But, Master, it's not my fault. I didn't ask for help. I tried to decline.
That is simply not true, Master Quilljake.
Ikunamo, uban chone alipa, istin koto. Wonki atacha kapa donka, jisa picha. Kutogi kumpa, jijino liamake chisa.
You. It's all your fault. You ruined my chances.
Ikunamo. Uban chone alipa. Istin koto.
What was he supposed to do? Did you deliberately set him up to fail?
Ubanya. Manchi doti puna puna. Kabuk nuni snemo. O kakiza spida perupa. Gadwa shiniko higa danulia.
I'm tremendously honored.
Getusta barawanga. Nesubur kobo pomo?
Yes. Yes, master.
Imache. Churon chika jiliska chanaga.
Come over here, Jedi, and spare a moment for a humble servant of the Matriarch. I promise, your other dealings will wait. My name is Vidariat Aeon. I minister to the bodies and spirits of the villagers, and I have a request. I speak of the Flesh Raiders. Of late, we've seen them growing stronger, and I know why.
What are the Flesh Raiders exactly? Where did they come from?
No one's sure. They were here when the pilgrims came to Tython. The Flesh Raiders have been experimenting, concocting an elixir that makes them ravenous. The ones who drink it go mad. Their lips froth, and they pounce like starving animals. It's black medicine, primitive and evil.
How could Flesh Raiders learn to do something like that?
I have no idea. Such wickedness is beyond our comprehension. We lack the numbers to attack the Flesh Raiders directly, and not even the Jedi could wipe the monsters from this world. But with our warriors' help, the Jedi could reach the Flesh Raider caves and destroy their vats of elixir.
Then count me in.
Thank you for this. Odemus Mare knows where the vats are hidden. He is our guard captain. Talk to him to learn the Raiders' secrets.
Jedi, I think I know what you've been doing. Vidaria sent you to speak with me. She told you about the Flesh Raider elixir, didn't she? How it makes the Flesh Raiders strong. Vidariat's been looking for a way to destroy the elixir, but she's making a terrible mistake. We shouldn't destroy the elixir. We need it. And I'll pay you well if you bring it to me.
What exactly are your intentions?
The elixir can make our guardsmen strong. Yes, it may change them, but it will work. We can defend our village and destroy our foes. Imagine, if the elixir can make a Flesh Raider powerful, what would it do for a pilgrim warrior? Bring it to me, and you will be rewarded, praised.
I won't help you feed the elixir to the pilgrims.
Fine. Obey the orders of an old woman and destroy the elixir. But pilgrim blood is on your hands. The elixir is in the caves beyond our village. I doubt Jedi can even come close to the vats.
Look well, Jedi. I'm glad the Flesh Raiders didn't hurt you. Did you destroy the Dark Elixir?
I've done as you wished.
You've rid the world of an evil thing. The Flesh Raiders may brew their Dark Elixir again, but we won't make it easy. I am grateful for what you've done. Take this gift with my blessing. For now, I leave you in peace.
Greetings, Matriarch. Master Orgus Din has sent me to help you fight the Flesh Raiders.
So the Jedi finally deigned to recognize my people's suffering. How noble. Nothing to do with the attack on your training grounds, I'm sure.
We didn't realize how great a threat the Flesh Raiders had become.
And now you seek help from the people you once ignored. My scouts have tracked the Flesh Raiders for months, watched them grow in strength. I will share what we've discovered. But only if you agree to protect my people. We suffer.
Mother. You need rest. Let me carry this burden for you.
With all due respect, time is a factor. I need that information.
This is my daughter, Rana Dalven. She and Scout Chief Morint here will speak for me. I must attend to other matters.
Personally, I don't care why you've come. As long as you destroy the Flesh Raiders. Ever since they got their new weapons and gear, they hunt us like animals. The enemy has a camp in the valley nearby. My scouts say the Flesh Raiders store their weapons and other tech in a cave.
Removing that technology will neutralize the Flesh Raiders.
We need to strike fear into the Flesh Raiders, sabotage their weapons, fix it so they blow up in their ugly faces.
How would we do that?
Their technology is standard Republic design. We could overload the power circuits and plasma coils. Here, I'll show you. Sabotage would thin the Flesh Raider numbers and eliminate their technological advantage.
If you brought that technology here, we could defend ourselves with those weapons.
This village is vulnerable to attack. You need better defenses.
This debate is pointless unless you can get inside that cave. You'll need one of the leader's access keys.
Find the Flesh Raider technology and do what you think is best. Good luck, Master Jedi.
Once they have all this, the Twi'leks can defend themselves. Tell me the whole story, and more slowly this time. What made the Flesh Raiders bring you back here?
Teach our soldiers how to use these weapons. Train them on the Twi'lek invaders.
When will we strike against the Jedi?
Patience, Caliph. The Jedi will fall when our army reaches full strength.
I never understood the need for restraining bolts anyway.
She died in my arms. You should have seen what those filth did to her.
I'm sorry, Seilu. We all share your loss.
For every one of us the Flesh Raiders butcher, we should kill 10. No, 100!
Will that restore your loved one to life?
Don't lecture me, Jedi. My wife is dead. Our people slaughtered. Where were you then?
Nothing I say will ever make you feel whole again. But we truly are doing everything we can.
What about exterminating those animals? The Flesh Raiders won't stop until we're all dead. Are you going to let that happen?
Perhaps your people would be safer if you left Tython.
This is our home. No Flesh Raider or Jedi will drive us out.
You made a good point. Shame he's too stubborn to hear it. People wonder why Jedi are forbidden to marry or have families. They don't see how attachments always lead to suffering. Passionate emotions can destroy a person. And Jedi destroyed by passion become something terrible.
T7 was captured by the Flesh Raiders. You'll want to see the holo recording he made.
While I deal with the droid, talk to Rana. I think her people are ready to help us, thanks to you.
The weapons and technology you brought from the Flesh Raiders, my people can defend themselves. You risked your life to help us. My people haven't had a champion for some time.
Jedi have a duty to protect and defend others.
And we promise to share our knowledge in return for that duty.
Scouts report that the Flesh Raider forces are gathering in strength. They already control the mountains around us, and now they're invading the ruins of Kaleth. My men spotted them at the remains of an ancient shrine, close to your Jedi temple.
Kaleth was a great city of Force users. Its ruins hold powers we still don't understand.
The Flesh Raiders are looking for something there.
We can't let them find it. Drive back those Flesh Raiders immediately. I have to take this droid back to the Council. That hooded figure in the holo, I know his voice. The situation is worse than I thought. Do whatever it takes to push the Flesh Raiders out of Kaleth. I'll send you reinforcements as soon as possible.
I'll hold the line until reinforcements arrive, Master.
If you see that hooded figure from the holo, do not engage him. I get going.
Did you just call me Jedi?
Jedi.
Master Orga sent us. We came as quickly as we could.
One of the Flesh Raiders I just fought called me Jedi. He could use the Force.
That's troubling. If the Flesh Raiders are learning the ways of the Force, it won't be on the side of light.
You sure made short work of this bunch. You ever leave survivors?
When was the last time you fought someone trying to kill you?
Besides my master? A few months.
This is no laughing matter, Padawans. This Flesh Raider carried a holocron. A repository of knowledge created by a Force user. Thousands of years old from the looks of it. Master Orgus was right. These natives are more advanced than we realized. They're learning how to fight us.
Master Orgus thinks he knows who's behind it.
I gathered as much, but he had no time to explain before sending us here. I wish we could stay, see this through, but Master Satil has ordered us to Coruscant on a special mission.
All those bad feelings the Council's been having? She thinks the Republic capital is the source.
I'm sorry to have to leave you, but the danger is past. These surveillance monitors will keep watch on Kaleth, place them around the ruins. The temple can then monitor any future incursions by our enemies.
What are we prepared to do if the Flesh Raiders return?
The temple's guards will respond to any invasion, and these surveillance devices will give us ample warning. May the Force be with you, Padawan.
I'm here, Master. What is it?
I'm on my way back to the Twi'lek settlement. Meet me there as soon as you can.
I'm already on my way.
Find me at the Matriarch's compound. Orgus out.
Master Kiwix told me what you found in Kaleth. A Flesh Raider who used the Force. He thought he was learning things from an old holocron. I wish that were true. The man who attacked you when you first arrived? His lightsaber had a familiar aspect. This droid's holo recording confirmed my suspicions. The hooded figure in that recording is named Bengo Moore. He was my Padawan, but he never completed his training. Bengo was in the Jedi Temple on Coruscant when the Sith destroyed it.
The Force was with him if he got out of there alive.
The temple was annihilated. Hundreds of Jedi died that day. We never recovered all the bodies. Bengo was strong in the Force, and the most gentle being I've ever known. For him to turn against the Jedi, he has to be stopped.
Apologies for keeping you waiting. Our people's matriarch, my mother, is dying.
That's terrible news. Will you be all right?
I wasn't expecting to lead our people for many years. My scouts have identified a Flesh Raider command base in the mountains. It's protected by an energy shield. The shield's power generator is hidden on a different mountain, in a well-guarded cave network.
That command base is probably coordinating all the attacks in the region. I need to get inside there. You up for knocking out the power generator?
When have I ever let you down?
First time for everything. Not that I'm worried. See if you can give the droid an opening to gather more intelligence. That energy shield is your top priority. Knock it out fast as you can.
Jedi, you came. I was afraid. I didn't think you'd make it. You have to be fast. You have to find my son before he's hurt.
I don't understand. What about your son?
I knelt at the temple gates. I begged for Jedi help. Isn't that why you came? The Flesh Raiders took him a week ago. They came at twilight. One of them was just covered in blood and scars. He dragged my son away. Listen, our scout saw Vio, my son, on Tytho's ridge. That's where the raiders have their camp. They say he's hurt. He's bleeding and limping, but he's alive. He's waiting for rescue.
I'm a Jedi. This is what we're here for.
If you can't find him on Tytho's ridge, look for a sign. Something he'd leave behind as a signal. He had a satchel with him. He could leave that. The Flesh Raiders will try to stop you, but I've seen Jedi fight. Help me, Jedi. Help him.
My dear Blair, these will probably be the last words I have to say to you. And I don't have long. I was a fool, Blair, as always. I shouldn't have come hunting alone. I knew that. But our little Rusa is so sick. And the doctor said that the teeth of the manga cats could make medicine. Cure her. I tried. I tried to get the teeth for Rusa. But the Flesh Raiders trained the cats to be vicious. So horrible. I'm sorry, my love. And so tired. I must sleep to gather my strength. In case the manga cats come back, I'll bring their teeth home. Somehow.
Jedi? Oh, thank the Matriarch.
Jedi talk. Jedi peace.
He wants to speak to you. He's too weak to fight.
Jedi peace.
He needed someone to help him communicate. That's why he took me away. Why he's letting us meet. I've been trying to teach him your language.
You mean he took you as a translator?
Yes. It's hard, though, and I can't tell when he understands.
Head thing, talk! Head thing, talk! Learn power!
I'm trying. Please, I'm trying. He thinks he has power. He thinks he can use the Force, and he wants Jedi to train him.
Why would he want that?
I know, I told him that. He really believes he's like the Jedi, though. He says he can feel the Jedi's power when he comes close to the temple. He says he can smell power in the rocks. It makes him strong. The other Flesh Raiders serve him because they fear his curse. But the Force overwhelms him. He needs to learn from the Jedi to control the power. He's weak.
You're forcing my hand here.
Take power. Hunt power. Go rock den. Head thing flesh.
He won't let me go unless you help him get into the Jedi temple. You can do that, right? Get the Jedi Masters to train him?
Letting a Force-using Flesh Raider live is too dangerous.
But...
Jedi!
I am... you... Thank you. I am grateful that you came for me.
I'm sorry, but that Flesh Raider needed to die.
Yes, of course. I can find my way to the village. After what you did, and without him watching me, I can make it on my own. More Flesh Raiders will be coming. Be careful.
Thank you.
You must be the Padawan who slaughters my people. Your misguided attacks change nothing. Your time is over.
Master Orgus is looking for you, Bengal.
Orgus won't find me. I'll find him. You executed my apprentice, Caliph. I can feel his death on you. I spent years training him. He was a good man, a principled man. Proud of yourself?
I didn't want to kill the man, but he left me no choice.
There's always a choice. You should have surrendered to the inevitable. Every so-called Jedi on Tython is going to die. That's a promise. Your entire order is weak. You've done nothing to stop the Sith Empire's advances.
I guess I missed the news about you winning the war.
I can't defeat the Sith until the Jedi are strong again. You people diminish the Force by your very existence. Enjoy this little victory. It's your last.
Jedi, you found my son. Thank you. He told me what you did. He's safe now. I'm glad his kidnapper is dead.
Is Vio okay? Last I saw, he was leaving the Flesh Raider camp.
Vio's scars are healing, and the Matriarch will tend to his mind. He'll be well again. You have my promise. Whenever the Elders speak about the Jedi, I'll speak too. My son will speak. This is our thanks.
With time, maybe the Jedi and your people can become allies.
Allies on Tython, and allies against the Flesh Raiders. We wish you well, Jedi. Goodbye, and all the best to you.
Oh, hello. You must be one of the Jedi. My name is Balea. How do you do? I don't mean to be rude, but I'd rather not talk for long. My daughter is very sick, and I'm all she has since my husband died.
I found a holo recording on your husband's body. He said these manka cat teeth would help your daughter.
You brought these for my daughter? Oh, this is what the doctor needs to make her medicine. I'm overwhelmed. I don't know what to say.
It was the least I could do.
You should be rewarded for this. Yes, wait, I know. Yes, you should have this. It was my husband's. It served him well, and now that you have saved my daughter's life, I hope it serves you well also. Thank you so much. I've got to tell the doctor right away so that he can make Rusa's medicine.
I shut down the energy shield. Any word on Master Orgus's mission?
No. My mother, she found peace during your absence. I am now Matriarch.
You don't have to go through this alone.
People who say Jedi have no feelings are wrong. Before he left, Master Orgus told me there is no death, there is the Force. He believes our essence lives on when we die and merges with the Force. I hope that's true.
Matriarch! Flesh Raiders broke through our defenses. They did something to our crop fields. They dropped strange machines in the soil. When a scout approached one, he collapsed with sickness. He crawled away from the device and began to recover, but there are many more machines still out there.
I've never heard of anything like this before.
If these machines can poison us, they can destroy our crops as well. Please help us. Jedi are strong. You can resist the machines and destroy them.
I'll take out as many of them as I can.
Hurry to the fields. I fear we don't have much time.
Destroyed the machines poisoning your crops.
I saw how you suffered out there. What you did was more than brave, it was heroic. Please, take a token of my people's honor. I'm sorry it can't be more.
I'm sure you can find better use for it elsewhere.
No, I insist. You deserve this. I should go inform everyone that the danger is over.
Finally put the Flesh Raider base out of commission. How are things on your end?
I spoke to your old Padawan over the hollow. He's doing all this so he can destroy the Sith.
Then it's not Sith himself. Good. If I can get to him, reason with him. At the Flesh Raider command base, I found coordinates to a number of secret camps. Too many to send only Jedi Masters. One camp is in the ruins of Upper Kaleth. That patrol you fought earlier was based there. Now's your chance to finish them off.
What if I run into your old Padawan?
If you see Bengal, retreat and contact me immediately. Be careful in those ruins. We haven't explored them all. Contact me when your mission's complete. May the Force be with you.
Edlin Berfia Kalin Tom Keret. A Tenger Kelet Wiesel me as.
What's your name? How'd you get here?
Ben Seji S.E.J. Kimge Atlas. Estavo lab meg minig uge. Oze disazos. Homa leban. Merega mosdu. Latlan felic. Degob es elenga agiob.
An alien commands the Flesh Raiders. Is he here?
Confai banche. Volt gira can. Is as ala soni parton as atla zokis zal.
Flesh Raider camp's out of commission, Master, but they were all Force users. They killed a Jedi named Lauta. His body is in these ruins. What should I do?
We'll reclaim our fallen later. Just got a distress call from the Twi'lek settlement. They spotted Bengal Moor. Our forces are spread out dealing with the secret camps. We're the only ones who can handle this. I'm on my way to the settlement. Meet me there.
Master Orgus responded to your distress call. I was to meet him here. What's happened?
Nothing. We didn't send any distress call. Things have been quiet since you left. I haven't seen or spoken to Master Orgus.
Someone sent Master Orgus a distress call from here. Who was it?
I'm sure it's a misunderstanding. Your master will turn up. Why don't you stay a while? You must be exhausted.
Stop it! What are you doing?
Matriarch, step aside. Handing over the boy's master wasn't enough. This Padawan has to die.
I told you to leave him alone. That was the pact.
Bengal Moor refused your terms. This is to save our people.
You lied to my face. How could you do that?
I had no choice. There are too many Flesh Raiders and not enough Jedi.
Bengal Moor came to me, said he'd end the Flesh Raider attacks if we gave him your master.
He asked us to kill you, too. But I said no. I told him we'd keep you here. You'd be safe. And my people would have a protector.
If we don't do what we're told, Bengal Moor will kill us all.
You don't want to hurt anyone. You want to leave here peacefully.
I don't want to hurt anyone. We should leave here peacefully.
Yes, better that way. Here, perhaps you can use these. We don't need them.
This was all a terrible mistake. It wasn't supposed to be like this. I was going to save you. Save us all.
Bengal Moor wants to destroy my order, and you handed him my master.
There's still time to save them.
Bengal Moor took Orgus to someplace called the Forge. Reactivate your droid. It might know where to find them. You can forgive me, can't you?
I don't condone what you've done, but I understand.
Thank you. I'm so sorry. Tell me what I can do to make this right.
Learn from this mistake. Spend your life atoning for what you've done.
I won't waste this chance. That's a promise. My people should hear what's happened. It's best if I tell them. I hope you find your master.
Bengal Moore took my master someplace called the Forge. Do you know where that is?
I am A4PO, Jedi Archivist. How may I help you?
Transmit everything you know about the Forge to my droid T7.
That area is considered highly dangerous. May I inquire why you need this data?
Flesh Raiders captured Master Orgus and took him there.
By the stars, what perfectly awful timing. The Temple Masters are all indisposed fighting Flesh Raiders. I will alert them immediately, but they may be unable to assist you. Transmitting data now.
I sensed you coming. Your fear betrayed you. You're weak. Like my old master, you will fall with him.
What happened to you on Coruscant? Why have you turned against the Jedi?
Not the Jedi. The sick, spineless cowards that have taken their place. The traitors who let the Sith slaughter millions. You weren't on Coruscant. You never saw our greatest cut down or watched the temple burn. I escaped that destruction to see my own master surrender to the Sith. They exterminated us, and he gave up.
That's why you brought Master Orgus here? To make him pay?
The weak will be sacrificed here to make the Forge stronger. The Jedi Order must be reborn from ashes. You've won. Why has the Force guided me to this defeat? You're stronger than any Jedi I've known. You could redeem the Order and destroy the Sith. I understand. You are the weapon I came to forge.
You don't have a destiny, Bengal. You're sick. You need help.
Don't deny the truth. Think. How else could you have beaten me? I have spent a lifetime learning the paths to power. That knowledge is now yours. Let me leave Tython and prepare the galaxy for your ascendance. I will deliver the gifts you need to reclaim your destiny.
You'll get the help you need, Bengal. But you can't leave here.
Padawan, I must have you to thank for being alive.
I captured Bengal Moore, Master. He's resting quietly.
You've done a great thing. He deserves a second chance. The horrors he witnessed on Coruscant broke him, destroyed the gentle Padawan I trained. You, however, faced a challenge beyond any trial I could assign. There's nothing more I can teach you. All that's left is for you to enter the Forge and construct your own lightsaber.
What is this place, Master?
The first Jedi came here to construct their lightsabers millennia ago. It's strong in the Force. Normally, we make Padawans gather materials themselves, but you've proven enough. These are all the physical components. The rest will come from your mastery of the Force. I'll carry Bengal back to the Jedi Temple and get him help. Meet me there when you're ready.
Thank you.
This weapon will be a light in the darkness.
Flesh Raiders are still a threat, but without Bengal's leadership, they'll be scattered and ill-equipped.
This temple could have been devastated. The entire order is in your debt, Padawan.
The enemy found weaknesses in our security. We have to guard against another Coruscant.
Agreed. And now we have concerns beyond the Flesh Raiders. Recent developments in the Twi'lek settlement demand a response.
Their matriarch betrayed me to Bengal, but she surrendered herself to us for judgment. You're doing, I understand. Good work.
You know the Twi'leks, Padawan. How do you recommend we proceed?
We created instability by refusing to help them. That has to change.
What happened to Master Orgus is almost unforgivable.
But if we do forgive and work with them, it can only improve both our communities. This young Jedi captured a fallen member of our order and saved this temple from destruction. I see no reason why he should remain a Padawan.
Your bravery, heroism, and sacrifice show great depth of character. You represent our best hopes for the future. You arrived on Tython a Padawan, but you leave a Knight of the Republic. May the Force be with you.
I promise to uphold every standard of the Jedi and Galactic Republic. This little droid and I have been through a lot. We're a great team.
Then I see no reason why you shouldn't stay together.
We're getting a priority signal from Coruscant. It's Master Kiwix.
Master Orgus, everyone. I've discovered a situation requiring further assistance. Our suspicions about Coruscant were correct. The dark presence we have long sensed is strongest here.
What could be worse than a fallen Jedi attacking us?
That's what we need to find out. The security of the entire Republic is at stake.
This situation calls for our very best. Master Orgus, you and your former pupil should join Master Quix on Coruscant.
Come to the Senate Tower as soon as you can. Master Quix, out.
No rest for us, my friend. Complete any unfinished business you have and take a shuttle to Coruscant.
I'll leave immediately, Master.
I need to wrap up some things before I go. Meet you on Coruscant.
Farewell. The Force will be with you. Always.